Alright everybody, welcome back. If you own a Harbor Freight solar panel, the Thunderbolt 100 watt, then you are familiar with their style of connections, the SAE connector. While it's okay to use in small setups, this wire is generally too small and the connections tend to overheat when you start bumping up the amperage. So, we are going to show you how to connect new wires into this junction box here and make it the standard MC4, which is right here. So that's the industry standard there, is MC4. That's what Harbor Freight provides, is the SAE. So the first thing you gotta do is locate your junction box back here. There's little tabs. You can get a hook back there and pop these hooks off, and you'll pull the cover off and you'll be exposed to the diodes and the leads of the wire. So you have to make sure you remember which side's positive and which side's negative on this thing. Positive happens to be on this side, negative happens to be on this side, but always check your panel because it could be different. We're gonna go ahead and unscrew these things here, and then you'll be tempted to take these screws off. They don't do anything but hold this backing plate on there. So we're actually gonna have to either cut or desolder these, and that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna desolder them and pull them out. All right, all we did was slide the new wire up inside there after desoldering the old wire, reconnect the old clamps or the old connectors there. Don't do like I did and burn through your junction box with the bottom of the soldering iron. We'll just have to put some silicone there or something. But now you have to re-solder the wires. And we're gonna go ahead and get some more solder and re-solder them in. There may be enough left over to just use the old stuff on there. So either way, you gotta make the connection here. You can fold them over or solder it. So we're gonna go ahead and re-solder it. All right, we went in and soldered everything. As you can see there, we got a good bond on both tabs. Globbed it on there nice and good. It's solid. We're gonna go ahead and put the backing cover back on, even with that little bit of damage we had from the soldering iron. Should just snap back in. Yep. All right, so the back snapped back on and we're gonna go ahead and plug it up and see what happens. All right, we got the panel hooked up there, coming in on the MC4, and it's bringing in about 25-26 watts. Because there is an overcast, in the sky right now. All right, we just wanted to show you with the MC4 connections on the Harbor Freight panel. We are pumping in over 80 watts when the sun is not behind clouds. As you can see, there's the connections running out to the solar panel there. So 81 82, we've seen a peak of 85, but again, there's cloud coverage out, so we don't expect it to be perfect. We'll compare the MC4 cables to the SAE cables in another video to see if it gives you any more wattage out of there, or any more stable wattage. But as you see there, it's doing just fine, coming in at 5.9 amps. If this helped, please smash the like button, share, and subscribe. Thanks.